It's time for a new series and new adventure.
That's right. And I am so excited and ready to go.
Oh, I am so excited. Did you know all good adventures have treasure?
Ooh, and I like treasure.
So do I. But they also have snakes, danger, and traps, and quicksand, and lions, tigers, and bears. Oh my.
Oh my, it's right. And did you say snakes?
I did. It's time for the LKIDZ show.
I didn't say that.
Yes, you did. You definitely did when you signed the waiver. You're gonna be fine. Okay. Start the show.
Hi, and welcome to the LKIDZ Show. My name is Pastor Emilio.
Yes, and my name is Pastor Evelani, and we are about to embark on an adventure to understand God's promises.
That's right, and we're going to dive into the story of Noah and the Ark.
Ooh, the story of Noah is a wild one and maps out the way to unlocking God's promises.
It really does, and with the new series comes a new verse.
Ooh,
so let's call out our little friend.
Ooh, we got to do it.
Okay. You ready?
Oh, I'm so ready.
Let's go.
Ty, did you like the introduction? You are such an adventurer.
That's right, look at him, he's got the hat and everything. We're ready to go.
Ty brought us keys. Thank you so much, Ty. We're gonna figure this out.
Thanks, Ty.
It looks like. Looks like we've got some keys here.
Wait. Pastor Evelani, LKIDZ, I think I know where those go.
You do?
Yes.
Well, to what? I don't see anything.
Follow me.
Oh.
It's called the Adventurer's Crawl.
Oh. That's happening.
That's right. You have to be very careful with this treasure. Very careful. So
crawl. The crawl continues.
All right.
Ooh. You have a good eye.
Thank you.
Did you guys see the treasure box? Okay, so let's open this up.
Right, yeah, be very careful.
I don't know. Yeah. Let's see which key.
Did that one work?
Oh.
I'm pretty sure it goes.
There we go.
Yes.
Okay. Ooh. All right.
Okay,
not the safest lock, I'll be honest. Okay.
Hey. It's treasure.
Oh, you gotta do that. Oh. Ooh, I like this. Very clever. Ty is very, very clever.
Most definitely.
And you know what? There is treasure in here because God's word is treasure and our verse is very, very valuable.
That's right.
Indeed. So let's go ahead and read it.
Okay.
This has got to be a good one. I mean, it was in a treasure box. Ooh, this is a great verse.
What is it?
It is Deuteronomy 31:8. Okay, I'm going to read it out. If you have your Bible, get it out.
Whoa, wait. Pastor Lovey, what is that?
Don't you worry about it. I know what I'm doing. Here we go. It's Deuteronomy 31:8.
Okay.
It is the Lord who goes before you. He will be with you. He will not leave you or forsake you. Do not fear or be dismayed. That is Deuteronomy 31:8. Oh my gosh. Really, that is such an awesome verse. But what? They've got to repeat that verse.
I think so. And I think there's a bunch of adventures
in
LKIDZ. They're brave. So, all right, ready, LKIDZ? In a brave, brave voice, repeat after me. Deuteronomy 31:8. It is the Lord who goes before you.
Yes.
He will be with you. He will not leave you or forsake you. Do not fear or be dismayed.
Don't be scared. Don't do it.
Man.
Oh my gosh.
There are some brave adventures.
Wow.
We're ready to go.
You guys sound so ready for an adventure. Seriously. Really.
That's right. But Pastor, I have to ask you something. Where'd you get that flashlight?
Oh, bro. Journey bag.
What is this?
Yeah, it's filled with things that I need for the adventure.
Okay.
And some of the cool treasures that I've actually found. I can show you. Watch.
Yeah, show me.
I got all kinds of good stuff. Okay.
All right.
I got this.
Okay,
hold on. This is too big for the bag.
Right.
It is the goblet of the forgotten forest.
What?
You don't even know about that. That was crazy.
That's a beast of a goblet. Look.
Oh my gosh.
Ooh.
Here we go. We got this. Ooh.
Wait a second. I think I've seen that before.
Oh, yes.
Where have we seen that before?
Forbidden Amazon. Bro, $10.99. I got like a steal. It was like
so it wasn't from the jungle.
Deals.
It was the
it was like a lightning deal. Right, I hit add to cart, pay now.
The
done.
Forest of the internet.
How
yes.
do you not have that?
Right.
Oh, and every good adventurer needs a Bible that
right.
fits in the adventure
most definitely.
Bag.
Yeah.
I mean, come on, bro.
We need God's word.
We definitely do. Oh, and this one. This was a this
what
one was
this?
A tough one to obtain.
What's this?
It's the box of forgotten memories. Forgotten memories. It's a really crazy. You can open it.
Okay.
You'd like.
I think I'll open it. All right.
Yes, go for it, man.
Forgotten memories?
Forgotten.
Like, are they gonna?
Memories.
Okay, ready? Ah! What the? There are no memories.
The forgotten.
There are no right. memories. This memories is... of me having a heart attack.
It's Freddy.
What, Freddy? Oh, I felt it.
Not. Also, Amazon.com. Oh, great deal. Man. Yes. All of these things.
In your journey bag.
Mm-hmm.
Well. Man, I would like a journey bag because I'm feeling a little unprepared, Pastor Evelani. I mean, I dressed the part, but I don't have all these gadgets and tools.
Hmm, okay. So, I don't know if I'm like a pro, but I mean, kind of.
I think so.
Okay, I have some stuff here.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Perfect.
Some people might not think that they have this whole adventure thing figured
right.
out.
Okay.
Sure. But on all adventures, you have to actually have a really good eye.
Hmm.
Mm-hmm. A good eye to be able to spot things out, like clues or things that look out of place that are different, okay?
Right.
And I have something in this book.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I think I'm ready. I want to be a good adventurer.
You do, okay. And I want you to also, and I want you to as well.
Come on, LKIDZ.
So in here are some ancient images.
Okay.
Ancient, I say. Ancient images. And we're going to look at them together.
Okay.
Are you guys willing to join in?
Help us out, LKIDZ.
You ready?
Let's have the eye.
We're going to, oh wait, we need these first too.
These are man, there is so much in your adventure bag.
Remember, spotting clues, things will look different. Okay, here we go, here we go. Okay, I've got mine.
Clues.
So let me get these. Okay,
clues. All right.
You're gonna get to see this image on the screen. It's only gonna show for 15 short seconds.
Dang.
15 short seconds.
Okay.
You gotta use your eyes. Look for something because in this image, one of these things is not like the other, okay? And you're
going
to see if you can spot it out. If you find it, yell it.
Yeah, shout out, kids. We need your help.
In my book.
Okay.
Here we go.
All right, image number one.
At the first, we'll get the next one out.
Okay.
The first image. We're going to look at it. Here we go. Go.
Go. Okay, so we're looking at it. All right.
Ooh.
Can we see it? There's up here in the spot.
I feel like I got to spot the one that's not like the other.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
I just feel like maybe down here, is that?
And I'm assuming that the time has run out.
Okay,
right. So, did you spot the thing that was different?
Hmm.
I think it's pretty obvious. Bro, that was Shrek.
Oh!
That was a Shaq.
I thought
Shrek.
It was, oh my.
Shrek, you do not belong. Did you not notice that? Did you not see that Shrek was like the totally wrong thing?
Oh, I was like,
bro,
oh, Shrek's with Spider-Man.
If Shrek is gonna save the day in your life.
Right? Oh man,
sad,
okay.
Sad day.
Okay.
Okay, so let's get ready. I'm gonna pull out the next image.
Okay.
Here we go.
Next image.
Next Kay. Image.
Come on, LKIDZ, tell me out. I need help.
You're gonna hear the timer go off when the 15 seconds is done, okay? Next image.
Okay, let's see what.
Ooh. I don't know what it is, but it's adorable.
Mm-hmm. I'm a villain. I think I saw it. I think I see it. Right there.
It seems like the time has run out. Did you find it?
Hmm.
I did. Did you?
I think I did.
Okay, what is it?
It's right down in the middle.
That's right. It is
that
a
puppy.
Little puppy amongst the stuffed animals. We found it. Next one. Let's
okay.
get out the next ancient image.
Ancient
that
image.
No one in the entire world has ever seen. Here we go.
Let's do it.
Ready? Look at it. Go.
A lot of Clark Kent here.
This is a super image.
A very super image.
Very ancient.
Very. Beyond ancient.
Yes. Ooh, I do see some things in there.
I think so too.
Oh, and the time is gone and the images. What was it? Did you spot the difference? What was the thing that was different? It was...
His head was turned?
Batman! Did you not see?
Wait, what?
Batman!
Right there! No, I did not. I thought it was, you know, the one that said like...
It's Batman. Okay, here we go.
Dang,
ready? 3, 2, 1, look at that image.
Okay.
We're gonna inspect. Ooh, once you see it, shout it out. What do you see? Can you find the thing that is not like the others? Ooh, I think I see it. I see it. Okay, did you see it? I see it. I think he sees it at the end. It's the little
it's a puppy.
He's hidden in the leaves.
He is enjoying that time in the
leaves. He looks like a stack of leaves. Poor guy. Okay, last one.
Okay, last ancient
image. This
one's
a tricky one. Here we go, and take a look. Go. You, what do you see, guys? If you see the difference.
There's some little.
Now I'm looking. Maybe the different thing is, maybe not what it seems.
Right? Is it in the background? Like the back?
Do you see it, LKIDZ? Okay. Oh, man. The time is up. The ancient image is left. What did you guys see? I think I found it. Did you find it?
Yeah.
What was it?
The cat.
There's a big old cat in that picture.
The big old whiskers, too.
You're an imposter.
You imposter.
Of course a cat would be trying to hide.
You dog.
Into the shadows of the
in the shadows of the
dog. The shadows.
Well, LKIDZ, that was some incredible practice.
I know.
I think so.
You know what? I think we are ready to jump into our lesson and start this adventure of Noah's Ark.
Okay, so then where should we start?
Okay, so that's good. You know, all stories and adventures have a backstory, and to better understand where our journey will take us, we have to have an understanding of where it all started.
That makes sense. So then we're gonna start when Noah was an itty weeny baby, the little Noah, rock my baby.
Okay, maybe not the start. What I meant was like our story takes place in the first book of the Bible, which is the start of the Bible.
Yeah.
Genesis. Right. So the part where baby Noah, bitty Noah,
baby.
Is more like 500 years old. That's where our journey begins. He was kind of ancient.
Okay, I got you. So at the time during Noah's life in Genesis, the whole world has rejected God.
Ooh.
And the only person on earth that still loved him was Noah.
Ooh, yes. And in Genesis, it says that God actually regretted making humans so much that he decided to wipe everyone out.
Yeah.
Except for Noah and his family.
Man, that,
yikes.
I know, right? Well, I think we should get to know him a little bit better then.
Get to know Noah a little.
Get to know Noah.
That's a great idea. So how about this? Let's start.
Getting our stuff ready.
Our journey. Let's do it.
I don't know where she's going, but stay right here.
After creation, after Adam and Eve, and after Cain and Abel, more people started to populate the earth. The more people there were, the worse things got. Adam and Eve had sinned, and now everyone was born sinful. People became wicked and evil, and soon forgot about God. There was at least one family who followed God's way. Noah, his wife, and their three sons. They were faithful to God. They served God. One day, God spoke to Noah and gave him an incredible task. God told Noah that he would punish the world because of its sin and send a great flood that would cover the entire earth. God told Noah that he would spare him and his family and that Noah should build a big boat called an ark. God told them exactly how to make it. They were to leave room for themselves, as well as a lot of animals from all over the earth. They began construction on the ark right away. It was hard work. They had to do it all by themselves, and it was a huge boat, hundreds of feet long. The people thought Noah was crazy. They laughed and made fun of him. But Noah preached to them and told them to repent of their sins and obey God. The ark was almost done. As Noah and his sons put the finishing touches on it, the people continued in their wicked ways and paid no attention to God's warning. When the time came and the ark was complete, God sent two kinds of every animal in existence to the ark. That was incredible. Noah and his family, as well as all their animals, were to stay on this big boat until the flood was over. Two kinds of every animal had a place on the ark. Two by two, they got onto the ark. Giraffes, elephants, lions, kitty cats, turtles, worms, bears, birds, and everything else. And then the flood came.
Oh, hi. I didn't see you there. It's me, Pastor Taylor. And today, I'm going to be your adventure guide into God's promises. But we're gonna go over some really cool animal facts along the way. So as you can see, I am in this deep, jungle. You can probably hear the birds and the monkeys. Ah, it's crazy, because it's so real. It's definitely not a green screen. And so what we're going to talk about today, other than God's promises, is kind of something that started it all. You know, when it comes back to sin and everything, we're going to talk about the serpent, the snake, okay? Now, the snake we're going to talk about today, is a boa constrictor, okay? And a boa constrictor, oh, not today, not today, not today. You are not, and I am not afraid of you, bro. I'm not afraid of you, bro. Give me my hat back. So it turns out, I was definitely not afraid of this snake. And this is kind of like a boa constrictor. It's like a little blue one, you know? That's pretty cool. So boa constrictors can grow up to be about 12 feet long and live up to 40 years old. That is old. That's older than I am. So some really cool things here, though, is that apparently boa constrictors are a primal snake. So they actually have little legs on the back of their bodies. Bet you didn't know that. I read it online today, in the jungle, where I'm at, right now. Anyways, so this snake tempted Adam and Eve into sinning at the beginning of all of this. And you'll learn a little bit more about that a little bit later. But what I do want to talk about today is someone who came a little after them. His name is Noah. And you just got done learning about him. Noah was set apart. He was different. And that's why God said, listen, man, you're faithful. I see that you're different than the world around you. And I want to take you to do great things for my kingdom. And so you might feel like sometimes you're alone, like the things you're doing are just so different from what everyone else in the world is doing. And that's okay, because God used a man who didn't fit in anywhere to do something incredible to save mankind. So I want you to do this. I want you to open your books to Deuteronomy. We're going to check out today's verse. Deuteronomy 31 verse 8 says, it is the Lord who goes before you. He will be with you. He will not leave you or forsake you. Do not fear or be dismayed. Wow, isn't that an incredible verse? See, I'm here to guide you to God's promises, right? And this promise is a freebie, okay? All you have to do is accept Jesus Christ and you get this promise. You don't have to be afraid. God's not gonna leave you behind. See, Noah may have saved mankind with his boat, right? And that's fantastic. But Jesus saved the entire planet when he died on the cross for your sins and for mine. And so have confidence knowing that if you've accepted Jesus, you get to stand on the promise that God never leaves you. He saves you from the troubles you're in. He's going to take care of us all. That's all the time we have for today. I am going to go walk back into this deep, dark jungle and see what we can explore. Until next time, kids, we'll see you later. Look at this totally real jungle. Wow, I'm hacking through these leaves with my machete. Isn't that crazy? It's so real and not a green screen.
Welcome back, LKIDZ.
Hey there. So you guys have been getting to know Noah. Get it? Gonna know Noah.
No Noah.
Yeah, yeah. And you know what? There's a really fun fact about Noah that you may or may not be aware of, and that is he was an animal expert.
Well, yeah, kind of a dumb moment there, because he had to have two of every animal on the ark. Yes. He had to have been an expert.
And then some, actually,
right? Exactly,
right?
Yeah.
Exactly. He did, and so that means he knew a lot about animals. So today we thought it would be what a great idea on this journey and adventure we are on to bring real animal experts here on the LKIDZ show with real animals.
The no experience.
I'm not excited, but I'm trying to be excited. So we're gonna get to know some animals. I don't wanna get to know them.
Excited.
They're here and I'm not a bad hostess. So
that's right.
And I'm brave.
Let's be like Noah, check these animals out.
So brave, let's bring out our very first animal, which I hope doesn't have teeth. Our first animal
has
arrived. It's coming in.
Oh, here it is.
A real animal expert. Her name is Joelle, and you look like a nice person, and you're leaving. Where are you going? She's supposed to be
not
an
to
expert.
Worry, my friends. Not to worry. I am your animal expert today, and I'm definitely an expert with all these animals. It's me.
We're Eve on a budget,
Sterwin.
Y'all. This is our animal expert.
That's right. That's right. That's I'm totally, really, actually an animal expert, and in no shape or form a sham. So what we have here is a Jackson chameleon. So these chameleons are the only chameleons with three horns like this. They're really cool. You can see they can change colors based on their mood and the environment they're in. And if you look at his little hands, he's got these like split claws that he uses to climb around the leaves.
He's like, why am I here?
He's ready to eat one
of these. He's like, how do I leave?
Watch your fingers. He will destroy your finger. Yeah.
He's not. Yeah. Look at him. He's seriously like, where's the exit?
Over 30 fingers.
But look
every
at his eyes. They're moving like independently.
That's right. They can move their eyes independently.
What's his name?
His name is Patrick.
Patrick!
Yes. That's Patrick the chameleon.
Patrick.
Oh. He's soft though. He's very soft.
Yeah. We've met Patrick. Patrick is wonderful.
Yeah. Let's go to our next animal.
Let's bring out the next animal. Patrick is gone. Our next animal is going to be coming out any second. And I'm a little nervous because I don't know what it's going to be.
This has been awesome.
Hello there.
Oh.
That's right. I'm back with another animal today.
Wow.
So this little gal right here is Rosie.
Can you move its face like to the other side?
Only if it wants to.
I want its butt near me, not its face.
So this is a Rosie boa. And this is actually a full grown animal. So
oh my gosh!
Oh my lord.
Hey, Bologna, it wants to give you kisses. Isn't that precious?
Precious.
It's so precious.
Its name is Precious?
It's Rosie. No, its name is Rosie.
What's name
is
just...
It's Rosie. Rosie the boa.
Why is it coming near me?
Because it likes you.
Why does it go near me?
It can tell that you love it. Okay.
I don't love it.
A lot of people, you know, and I want to say this to the kids. A lot of people have a fear of these animals because they don't see them very often. Kids, should Pastor Ivalani hold the snake?
Oh my gosh.
I think it's a pretty unanimous decision.
Hold on. It's not real. This isn't real.
It's so real.
That's not you touching me. Why does it feel like a person?
It's okay. It was for sure my arm. let your hand down over here underneath my hand. Let your hand down. Put your hand up. Pastor Ivalani, put your hand up.
Pastor
Ivalani. Put your palm up.
I'm laughing, but I'm really crying.
Just keep your arms out like this.
Skin feels like skin.
I know, it's really cool. Put both your hands up like this. Ready? I'm gonna transfer the boa to you. Okay. You just want to stay stable.
It is so soft, Pastor.
Pretend,
so soft.
Pretend you're a tree. Pretend you're a tree. Okay.
I'm not a tree.
And just don't move spray.
I can't see because my eyes are all tears. Oh my gosh. Oh my. There's a tear. Oh my god. Oh my gosh. It's touching me. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
You are doing so good, Pastor Ivalani.
Oh my gosh.
Very good. Very good. I got it.
Guys, I think it's
time.
Oh my gosh, I'm not crying.
I think it's
time. I'm so brave.
Guys, didn't Pastor Ivalani do so good? Look at her.
Wow, that is such a cool animal fact. I love this, and I can't wait to see the next animal.
Well,
I think we're done.
I'll go get them right now.
Well, so you know what? How about we just take a little break because I cry. I'm crying. I didn't cry. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore.
Well, Pastor Ivalani, I say we give them the video.
What he said.
There you go.
That's a great idea. This game's going to
be. Have you ever played the game, one of these things is not like the others? How it works is you have four things, like these, and you have to figure out which one is not like the others. So point to it if you know it. If you guess this one, you're right. This hot dog is not like the other foods because it's not a vegetable. Because if it was, I would have become a vegetarian a long time ago. All right, let's try another one. This one's gonna be a little bit harder. So we got these four things here. Okay, all right, point to it if you know it. Okay, if you guess this one, you're correct. Because even though these are all animals, a monkey isn't a farm animal. Because if it was, I would have become a farmer a long time ago. Just a vegetable-eating farmer. Because I'm eating hot dogs with my monkey farm. So sometimes the answer is obvious that one of these things is not like the others, and other times it's a bit harder to tell. When we look at the life of Noah, we see someone who was so clearly not like the other people around him. He just stood out, like a hot dog on a vegetable tray, which is kind of weird. By this point in Genesis, the world had grown to be completely wicked. Genesis 6:5-9 says this, "The Lord saw how great the wickedness of the human race had become on earth, and that every inclination of the thoughts of the human heart was only evil all the time. The Lord regretted that he had made human beings on the earth, and his heart was deeply troubled. So the Lord said, I will wipe from the face of the earth the human race I have created, and with them, the animals, the birds, and the creatures that move along the ground. For I regret that I have made them. Yikes. You see, when we sin, it hurts God. He hates it. And by this point, the world was filled with sin. People were lying, cheating, stealing, murdering, and going their own way in every area of their life. So God regretted making the human race. But there was one person who was not like the others. The Bible goes on to say, but Noah found favor in the eyes of the Lord. This is the account of Noah and his family. Noah was a righteous man, blameless among the people of his time, and he walked faithfully with God. Noah stood out. He didn't go with the flow. He followed God. Even when the whole world around him was going their own way, he still made choices that honored God. Because of that, God used Noah to save the human race. But as time goes on, we see in the Bible that sin crept back in. And it always would, until someone would come to change that forever. So we needed a new savior of the world. But this time we needed a savior that would defeat sin once and for all. The story of Noah, the story of the world being saved through one man, points to a much greater story in the Bible. It points to a much greater savior in the Bible. In fact, it's who the whole Bible is pointing to. Someone who, like Noah, was not like the others, but even more extreme. Like if Noah stood out like a hot dog on a vegetable tray, this guy stood out like a rocket ship in the forest, or like the sun in the darkness. He was not like others at all. And his name was Jesus. And he lived a life free from sin and saved the world from sin once and for all. Just like Noah used the ark to save humanity, Jesus used the cross to save us from sin that was absolutely destroying us. Incredible. So now that we have been saved from sin, what should our response be? We should live like Jesus lived. We should stand out. We should make choices that honor Jesus every day because of the great sacrifice Jesus made to save us from sin. We shouldn't just live how everyone else is living because it's comfortable. Sometimes following Jesus is uncomfortable, and that's okay. Just understand that if you find yourself sticking out or not fitting in as you follow Jesus, you're in good company. Noah did this, and Jesus did this even more. In fact, Jesus even said, if the world hates you, keep in mind that it hated me first. It can be hard to stand out and not be like everyone else sometimes, but remember, when we follow Jesus, we have God's Spirit inside of us to help us make choices that honor Jesus. So we can be one of those things that's not like the others.
All right, welcome back. I am feeling a lot better. I talked to Jesus, had a moment, got some tissues. Okay, and we have another animal
that's
coming
right
out, and Pastor Taylor, our animal expert, is coming in with our animal right,
that's right
now. I can
this
see
Noah experience has been awesome.
And he came in correctly this time. He didn't just pop out of nowhere.
I did not magically pop out from behind the table this time.
Oh.
So this is Zero. Zero is a bearded dragon. So this is actually a full-grown animal. She's about a year and a half old. And it's called Zero because this is a zero pigment bearded dragon.
So, okay, so that's super cool.
Yes, very cool.
So do you know what Zero is looking into my soul?
There is a lot of colors of these guys. And so this zero pigment here. Something that's interesting is if you were to take two zero pigment bearded dragons, it actually wouldn't make a zero pigment bearded dragon.
Well, Zero's looking like
They're a bit spiky. So yeah, but she's kind of ready to go back home. So
she's looking like she's had enough of the
that is awesome.
Show.
Yeah. That is so cool.
Zero looked me in the eyes and was like, I'm over this. Okay, so
do it, Pastor Avalani. I want to say, God's design is incredible. I mean, look at this animal.
Look at him.
It's crazy.
Would you like to touch
it? Go ahead.
If I pretend to touch it?
I think
you don't have to pretend.
He's ready to go home.
So soft.
Wow. You're totally really touching him, too. That's crazy. Wow.
Zero is like, what a lovely
wild
texture.
That is so wild.
Yeah. Wild.
How cool am I? I touched Zero. So, Zero, thank you for joining us. And you look like uninterested. So we're going to let you go. Chill out.
He's giving you the stink eye.
He's giving you the stink eye.
Yeah. Come on, Zero. Let's
say bye, Zero.
Bye, Zero. And there we go. That was an awesome animal. Let's bring out our very next animal.
Hey, everybody. Okay, so we are back. We actually have a special friend with me today. This is Thor, and this is Thor's special friend who handles Thor.
You're back. You left us. You abandoned us earlier.
Thor is a reticulated python.
You guys can come closer, because I want to share the table with you.
And this is a beautiful animal. Okay, so this animal right here can grow up to 30 feet in the wild. So this is a little guy compared to what you can see.
I touched it.
Okay. Yeah, it's a beautiful animal. This yellow coloration is just gorgeous.
Like a banana.
You know, yes. I just noticed, like, the snakes, like, they like me.
They sure
or they
do.
Don't like
they sure
me.
Do.
Then that's a problem. So, it's real, so.
Okay,
so, okay.
That's from Ivolani.
What do you mean, Ivolani?
It's time to face your fears, you know.
Oh my God.
Look at this. God promises us in Luke 10 that we've got authority over these animals, you know. And just like, you're doing great. Look at this. Oh, you've got a snake on your shoulders. You're doing great.
Oh,
you're doing great.
That is awesome. That is incredible.
Look at me. I'm an adventurer. Look at
it is
that.
Incredible.
Incredible
oh,
animals.
Thank
my.
You.
And I think there's no better replacement than just getting the real thing and being able to handle it yourself.
Right?
Okay. Wow. So,
okay.
That, did you get to hold it? You made me.
I held, no, I held
no, like
it.
On
it was
you.
Great. No,
like,
it
put
was
it
great.
On him.
Pastor Emilio.
Put it right. On him.
Bro, we got to get you. Got to get you. Under
not next
the
to
weight
me.
Of
that's right.
He's kind of chilling okay. On my arm. I feel really sweet. He's like cuddling with me.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
He is.
So, again, I want to say, kids, there's a big misconception about these animals.
No, there's not. Not
unless
at all. If you think you're afraid of snakes, let me tell you, you are. If you don't think you're afraid of snakes, you are.
But none of these animals we've got here today.
I'm not here to confidence boost you. This is so. This is insane.
This is wild.
None of these animals are venomous. Okay, so even if someone was gonna get bit, it's not like we got to make a hospital visit or anything. It's just gonna take off your arm. That's it. So it's cool. It's totally cool.
Okay, I think Thor's ready to go.
Thor,
he's.
All right, Thor, come
Pastor.
With me, buddy.
Emilio. Wow.
Thank you, Thor.
Wow. Well, we have to give a round of applause for our animal experts and the one that bailed on us in the beginning. That's okay. She's still, we know she's the real deal here. So.
Thank you, Miss
yes.
Joelle.
Well, thank you, Miss Joelle. And
that, Miss Joelle.
That is not what Thor looks like at all in the movies.
Yes,
so
yes. Well,
I would have preferred to meet that Thor. That would have been much cooler for me.
I do want to say thank you guys for having me on the show. It was
thank
great.
You.
All right,
and you know,
yes.
Maybe, kids, you'll see me again to help guide you into the promises that God promises us.
Mm.
Promises, the promises. You'll
all
figure
the,
it out.
All
promises,
the
promises.
Promises.
It.
Yes.
Well, that's been it for our animal experience. I am going to go cry in the corner and also high-five myself because I held a snake today.
You
see how brave
it.
I am? Not that brave, you but that's okay. It. Check it back in just a minute.
Welcome, explorers. I do hope you've been paying attention along the journey. Let's find out, shall we? In a Bible story, how old was Noah when he finished building the ark? Was he A, 80, B, 100, C, 600, or D, 1,000 years old? You have 5 seconds to lock in an answer. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. If you answer C, 600 years, well, guess what? That's correct. And as we learned in our Bible story, the world had been taken over by sin, and God was disappointed and wanted to end mankind. But Noah was a man that stood out from the rest of the world, and for that, God spared him and his family. God instructed Noah to build an ark that would keep him safe from a flood that would destroy the entire world. Noah obeyed and trusted in the Lord. God saved Noah with an ark and saved us by sending his perfect son, Jesus. Well, LKIDZ, the journey continues. Until next time.
Well, today was most definitely a wild adventure.
Wild would be one way to describe that.
Not sure if I will ever actually rephrase. I will never do that again.
Yeah, I agree. But you know what was awesome? learning about Noah.
Yeah, okay. I did enjoy that part of our journey today, right. And also better understanding the promises that God made to save us. Like, how awesome is that?
Right, and I really love the promise that is just filled in God's word. In fact, there are 8,810 promises, to be more specific.
What?
Right?
That is a lot of promises. And the best part is they are accessible for all of us. God wants to fulfill his promises in our lives.
He really does. And you see, LKIDZ, later on in the Bible, long after Noah's story has passed, sin stuck around and sin continued to separate us from God. But God loved us so much that he promised to send us a savior that would give us freedom from sin and death and give us eternal life with him.
That's right, and that's so exciting. This way, and the only way, is Jesus. Mm-hmm. See, Noah used the ark to save humanity and continue the human race, and Jesus used the cross to save all of us from sin and bring salvation.
Exactly, so right now, we want to give you, LKIDZ, the opportunity to be free from sin and accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior.
And maybe you've already accepted Jesus, but have been living in sin and want to journey back to God. We want to pray for that too.
So LKIDZ, let's bow our heads and let's close our eyes. And if you want to join us in this prayer, please lift your hands on the count of three. Ready? One, two, three.
Wow, oh my gosh.
That's
Look
incredible.
At all of those hands.
Wow.
And mentioning hands, we lift our hand as an acknowledgement to say that we choose Jesus. It's a public display saying that we're doing that right now. So I just want you, if you did lift your hand, you're gonna repeat after me this special prayer and put power in your words. Here we go. Dear Heavenly Father, we love you and we thank you for sending your perfect Son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for me. I believe in my heart and say with my mouth, you are my Lord. I ask you to forgive me of all my sin. And I thank you for saving me. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Oh, awesome, LKIDZ.
What?
There we go.
Okay, yeah,
Let's do it. Ready? Oh, that's it. That was for you, LKIDZ.
Listen,
I cannot wait to see what we're going to learn next in our adventure.
Ooh, yes, because today was pretty great.
Yeah.
And guys, we are just getting started. And you know what? It's time for us to go.
Let's go.
Adventure calls. We'll be right back.